I'm Rich Johnson with SiteTech NorCal. I am the support and product specialist for SiteTech NorCal. Today we're going to talk a little bit about our Trimble Rover, specifically our SPS Rover running the SCS 900 software in configuration with the TSC3 data collector, which you see here, as well as our SPS 882 smart antenna. SPS 882 smart antenna utilizes both GPS and GLONASS satellites, meaning regression satellites, simply because, well, their strength in numbers. More uptime, more accuracy, means more production. Here we have the TSC3 data collector, which I said runs the Trimble SCS 900 software. Well, from a hardware standpoint, it's a pretty rugged, robust data collector. It has a lot of key features built into it as well. It has a front and rear facing camera, so you could actually use this to take as-built data with a photo attached to it. It has a built-in GPS as well, so we can use that for geotagging any of our photos. One of the other abilities we can do with our rover is to actually not use an on-site base station. We have what is called IBSS, or Internet Base Station Service, that we can use to actually access the base connection with the rover through the internet. This TSC3 here actually has a SIM card in it. We're using an AT&T 3G connection to actually dial into a base station stream. Basically what we do is we have a base station set up, and it's actually set up on the internet, and we have a dial stream that they can connect to over the internet, connect to that base station, and use that offsite base station for our position. So here's our SPS 882 smart antenna. Runs on a 900 megahertz frequency for our communication link to the base station. Here on our front panel, we can power the unit up, and we have three different icons on there with representing different things. You can see the flashing one right now is our power indicator, and that shows that we have, when it's solid green, it shows that we have plenty of battery life. When the thing starts flashing, it actually tells you that you have 20% battery left and it's time to change your battery. Now the one that just started flashing amber is our satellite indicator, and that shows us that we are actually tracking satellites. Now at this 1 hertz pulse rate, that means we're tracking more than 5 satellites, which means we can initialize and work. If it's flashing at twice the rate, we are less than 5 and we will not be able to initialize our signal. The middle light, which is not blinking, represents when we have a connection to the base station. So we have a radio link talking to and from the base to get our corrections.